So what they have done is reveal a huge amount of talent that exists in Santa Fe among artists and a little bit among writers and among people in general that has not really gotten that much visibility. So they've done something, I don't really want to say from the bottom up, but their curatorial position seems to be very, very wide.
I don't know, I kind of look at Axel as the ice cream truck of art. And just when I see the truck around, I'm just always feel good. It's exciting, it's the quintessential pop-up experience.
So Axel, to me, is more engaged in us. It's just warm, you know, it's nice.
Axel has brought an energy, a vision, and something uniquely interesting to the Santa Fe.
I like the idea of mobility and also this kind of populist taking art out of, you know, white boxes and an entirely commercial endeavor and making it about an everyday experience, and I just really appreciate the generosity.
While a lot of people talk about the creative or cultural economy of Santa Fe in big terms and often in terms that really just further an economy that is not healthy and is just a sort of buyer, seller, storekeeper economy that's non-sustainable, I think Jerry and Matthew and Axel have been actually by example demonstrating a different kind of economy for our community. One that's much more in tune with creativity and art beyond simply profession or marketplace. And so pleased to be a small part of anything that promotes those kinds of local and small is beautiful values.
It's artist-driven, artist-derived, artist economy, and Axel's like at the forefront of that. In a way, it's the future of not just art in Santa Fe, but the art world. Paradigms are shifting, and Axel's part of it. It's great. It's fantastic.